Hello, Sophie here. Let's talk stamps again. If this unhinged thumbnail from my previous video on the topic doesn't give it away, this is my favorite thing about painting with grease pencil. And I am so excited to get into the changes I've made to my stamp making process because it's pretty massive, in my biased opinion. So if I open my starter 2D animation blend file, which I'm constantly modifying, in my materials tab, I have three new materials, which I've called pencil. They all have a stroke material, simple, no settings changed, as well as a fill material with a texture style and an image inserted into the texture. And so what makes these different is that for my previous method of using stamps, I would insert into the texture a PNG image with transparency, and it was just a single image. I would check on the box for clip image, and then within my strokes, I would get that image. And so I would use these by layering different images on top of one another for texture. I could use the transform fill tool in edit mode to move, rotate, and scale the image. And so I would still use this method now if all I wanted to do was add that specific image to my piece, more for having the image itself and less for having it as a texture. But generally, when I would add stamps in this way, it would be to add them as textures. And it works. I've gotten results that I am really proud of with that method, but it was a fairly tedious process. So before I explain my new method, I want to share three images for context. They're all from the same artist, and I'll link down below where I found them. And so these are, in my opinion, overall beautiful artworks. And then you zoom in, and there are these little intense bursts of color. This is something I've always loved, but these pieces have something different about them. It's not just the saturated colors that I love, it's also how they exist in these little bubbles throughout the piece. These little self-contained bubbles, many of which are within a border. I don't know why, but seeing this just really sparked something in me. And so over the months, I've been trying different ways to get this look without much success, and then one Monday morning, out of nowhere, I had it. I now don't check the box for clip image, and instead, I use repeating image textures that I create. I have some in black and white, some in color, and so I like to modify the blend value slider depending on how much I want vertex colors to affect the texture. And so what I love about this is that it makes the process of adding these textures a lot more seamless. I just draw the strokes however I want, I create the shapes that I want, and generally I keep the texture image as is. But of course, I still have the option to use the transform fill tools on specific strokes. And so, with this new method, because I'm not trying to make a square and then position the stamp how I want, I'm just making strokes, and these strokes happen to have a really cool texture attached to them. This now means that I can make use of those strokes. I find this combination of stroke and fill materials really exciting. I mainly use this brush when I paint, and so in the stroke settings, I've given it some randomization to the hue, saturation, and value. They also affect the stroke as a whole and are affected by pen pressure. And what I find pretty cool is that this randomization affects only the vertex color of the stroke and not the fill. And I just really love the variety in strokes that I can get. More of the stroke will show up if I press hard and scribble in strokes. And more of the fill texture will show up if I press lightly and draw looser lines. Something else I love is that in vertex paint mode, I can use either the replace or draw tool to change the colors of my strokes, and I can modify the stroke and fill colors independently of one another using this drop-down menu. I love it. And so I have my folders of hundreds of images to use as stamps. I've been collecting them for months, and now I've been slowly converting them into repeating textures. And so I've been creating them as I've been making art pieces and wanting certain specific textures. And so what I'll do is I'll pick an image I want to use, bring it into Krita, Control R to select, and then hold Shift to square select and choose an area. This will depend on the look that I want to get. For some stamps, I want the texture to fill almost the whole area, while for others, their purpose is to add a grainy look, a very irregular texture, and so I do want holes in the final image. Then C and Enter to crop, and then in Image, resize canvas. I multiply each dimension by 2, and then I select this option to have it resized this way. Then I press Control A to select everything, Control C, Control V to copy paste, then up in Layer, transform, flip horizontally, then Control E to merge down, Control C, Control V, and then Layer, transform, flip vertically. What did I just create? And then I save. And so these already have transparency. You can see how I made that in my previous stamp video. There's a dedicated section all about that. And then all that's left to do is to insert them. What have I been making? I don't know. And so one thing about these stamps is they tile very weirdly, very obviously. They do not look great on a huge area like that. And so I wouldn't use them for a huge area like that, unless I planned on layering a lot of other strokes and textures on top of them. It can still make for a pretty interesting base coat, but for little areas, they are perfect and I adore them. My favorite so far has been this rainbow texture. So what I've been striving for lately with my art is to make pieces that read clearly overall, but have these accents of color, these pops, when you look at them closely. And the closer you look, the more little textures and details you can see. I've talked about this before, but my journey of art making involved a long time spent focusing only on the end result and not enjoying the process, and I almost quit. That is a miserable way to go about making art. I paint this way purely because it's fun. It's exciting. That's the only reason. And that's a pretty good reason. It keeps me coming back to my laptop day after day and pick up my stylus day after day. And I also do feel like the amount of unpredictability in this method helps to curb my perfectionism, allows me to not get too caught up in trying to make each stroke perfect, precise, exact. So that is my updated method. I hope you enjoyed watching me get excited about this for the third time. You can like and subscribe for more grease pencil and animal art. You can find me all over the internet at Sophie Jantak, though Instagram is my personal favorite place to hang out, and you will see me the most over there. I hope you're doing well. I will see you again very soon. Take care. Bye.